So, I, Pradeep Kaul, lecturer in chemistry, am again before you with a new topic, continuing with the unit surface chemistry. Today's topic is difference between true solutions, collides, and suspensions. Before discussing various points of distinction between true solutions, collides, and suspension, first we should have a brief idea of these terms. That is, what are true solutions, what are suspensions, what are collides. So, let me give you some examples so that we can understand these three terms. Dear students, in daily life we find certain mixtures. We can get mixtures by combining two components, sometimes three components, and we get different solutions. And to those solutions, sometimes we call them as true solutions, sometimes we call them as suspensions, and sometimes we may call them as collides. Now these components, suppose we have binary components, by binary solution or binary mixtures. By binary mixtures we mean which has only two components. So those mixtures containing only two components are known as binary component, these binary mixtures. Now these binary mixtures since have two components, one component is taken in larger quantity and the other one is mostly taken in smaller quantity. The component that is taken in larger quantity is termed as solvent. And the other component taken in smaller quantity is known as solute. So, in other words, we can say that solute and solvent, they combine to form solutions. Now, since we have here three types of mixtures, one is true solution, another is collide, and the third one is suspension. Now, what is difference between them? To what mixture we call as true solution, to which mixture we should name it collide, and which mixture we should name it as suspension. It all depends upon their particle size. When in case of binary mixtures, if we have a component A and a component B, suppose we combine them. Here again we have two components, say C and D, and here we have E and F. So we have three mixtures taken in three containers. AB, this is another component, this now just see, in the first case we have particles and the particle size is similar. All the particles that I have shown here by means of dots, they are similar in size. Not only similar, but their size is very small and their size should be less than 10 raised to power minus 9 meter. So what is a true solution? Suppose it is a true solution. I can term this mixture as a true solution if the particle size of these particles is less than 10 raised to power minus 9 meter, or less than 1 nanometer, or less than 10 angstrom, or we can say less than 1000 picometer. So in other words, we can say that 10 raised to power minus 9 is equal to 1 nanometer. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 angstrom, and 10 angstrom is equal to 1000 picometer. So if the particle size of a mixture made up of only two components is less than this size, 10 raised to power minus 9 meter, then that mixture is known as true solution. And please note that since the particles, all these particles are similar in size, they are of the same size, so such a mixture is known as homogeneous mixture. So what is a true solution now? So true solution is a homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture means its particles have similar size. Homogeneous mixture whose particle size is less than 10 raised to power minus 9 meter. So it is all about a true solution. Now I shall come to this one. Now see, in this container, these are particle size, bigger particle size, very bigger particle size. So if two components make a mixture and the particle size is greater than 10 raised to power minus 6 meter, greater than, not smaller than, bigger size, this was less than 10 raised to power minus 9 meter, it is greater than 10 raised to power minus 6 meter. If the particle size is greater than 10 raised to power minus 6 meter, it can be 10 raised to power minus 5 meter, it can be 10 raised to power minus 4 meter, greater, then this mixture is known as suspension. So what is a suspension now? Suspension is a mixture of two or more components which has a particle size greater than 10 raised to power minus 6 meter or greater than 1000 nanometer, or greater than 10,000 angstrom, or greater than 10 raised to power 6 picometer. But these particles are not of the same size, so it is not a homogeneous mixture. Suspension is never a homogeneous, it is a heterogeneous mixture. So suspension is a heterogeneous mixture in which the particle size is greater than 10 raised to power minus 6 meter, or these. Now coming to this one, this is the intermediate class between the true solution and the suspension. So what should be the size here? Size should be between these two, that is between 10 raised to power minus 9 to 10 raised to power minus 6 meter, in between these, that is lesser than 10 raised to power minus 6 meter but greater than 10 raised to power minus 9 meter. If the particle size is in between this, or in between 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer, or in between 10 angstrom to 10,000 angstrom, or between 1000 picometer to 10 raised to power 6 picometer, then that mixture is known as collide. So what is a collide now? In collide, again, you find that the particle size is not same. They have different particle size. So it is not again homogeneous, it is a heterogeneous mixture. So your collide is a heterogeneous mixture in which the particle size ranges between 10 raised to power minus 9 to 10 raised to power minus 6 meter. So this is all about the definition of this true solution, the collide and the suspension. Now we can distinguish between these three. We shall take different properties and then we will differentiate between suspension, the collides and the true solution. So first property that I am taking for distinction is particle size. Particle size, as I just discussed, that particle size should be less than 10 raised to power minus 9 meter in case of true solution. In case of suspension, it should be greater than 10 raised to power minus 6 meter. And in case of collide, should be in between these two, that is between 10 raised to power minus 9 to 10 raised to power minus 6 meter. These are other units of particle size. So this was one, particle size. Then another is nature. Nature I just discussed, whether the mixture is homogeneous or heterogeneous. I just told you that a true solution is always homogeneous in nature. That is, its particle size is same. As far as our colloid and suspensions are concerned, their particle size is not similar. That is not same. That is different particle size. So they are both heterogeneous in nature. So it is all about the nature of the true solution, the colloids and the suspension. Coming to another point is visibility. Visibility means whether we can whether the particles of these mixtures are visible. If they are visible, whether they are visible with naked eyes or by means of some microscope. So let us come to its visibility. As far as the particles of true solutions are concerned, they are invisible to naked eye. Their particle size is very small. As I just discussed, their particle size is less than 10 raised to power minus 9 meter. So we can't see those particles with naked eyes. As far as the colloids are concerned, their particles can be seen, but again, not with naked eyes, by using high power microscope known as ultra microscope. So its particles, the particles of colloids, can be seen only under ultra microscope. As far as the particles of suspension are concerned, since their particle size is very large, they can be seen with naked eyes. And even with microscope, they can be also seen. So this is all about visibility of true solution, colloids and the suspension. Then coming to another property, that is settling. Settling means whether its particles settle down on their own or they require some mechanical method to settle down. For that purpose, let us discuss settling. The particles of true solution, since their size is very small, they are homogeneous in nature, they are so mixed that they are all similar, so they do not settle. The particles of true solution do not settle owing to their similar size, owing to their very small size. As far as the particles of colloids are concerned, they settle, but how? On centrifugation only. By centrifugation, what we mean? By centrifugation, we mean by spinning. For example, we remove skimmed milk from normal milk. By spinning, that spinning is known as centrifugation. So the particles of colloids, they can settle, but how? On centrifugation only, not on their own. While as suspension particles, the suspension mixtures, they settle under their under gravity. They do not require any centrifugation. Their particle size is larger, they can be visible, so they settle down. So this is settling. Then another point is appearance. Appearance means if we look at them, how they appear to us. As far as our true solutions are concerned, if we have a true solution in a glass tumbler, we can see through it. If we see, we can, and that means light can pass through it. So it is transparent in nature. So true solutions are transparent in nature. As far as the colloids are concerned, they are generally transparent. Some of them may be translucent, but most of the colloids are generally transparent. As far as suspensions are concerned, they are always opaque. That is, light do not pass through them. So they are opaque in nature. So it was appearance. Now coming to diffusion, another property. By diffusion, we means intermixing, whether its particles intermix or not. Since its particle size, the particle size of true solution is very small, so they diffuse very rapidly. As far as our colloids are concerned, they colloids also diffuse, but not rapidly, slowly. And as far as the diffusion of suspension is concerned, they may diffuse. It is not always necessary that they should diffuse. They don't diffuse, rather. They don't diffuse at all. True solutions diffuse rapidly. So colloids diffuse slowly, and as far as suspensions are concerned, because their particle size is bigger, larger particle size, so they do not diffuse. Now coming to another special property, Brownian moment. First, let us know what Brownian moment is. Brownian moment, the name Brownian moment is given after the name of the scientist who gave this term. His name was Brown. and this moment is known as Brownian moment. What does this moment mean? This moment mean whether, suppose I have mixture here, if its particles move in all directions, if its particles move in random, at random, in all directions, then this moment is known as Brownian moment. So Brownian moment is nothing. Brownian moment means the movement of particles in all directions is known as Brownian moment. So about Brownian moment, true solutions do not show this effect. They don't show Brownian moment. While as the colloids and the suspension, both of them have the characteristic feature of Brownian moment. And then coming to Tyndall effect. Now what is Tyndall effect? Let me come to this effect. Suppose I have a solution here. This is suspension. This is colloid. If light is passed, a beam of light is passed through solution, it will pass through it straight way. If a beam of light is passed through suspension, what happens to it? It scatters like this. It scatters. And this scattering effect is known as Tyndall effect. Similar happens to the this very colloid. So what we mean by Tyndall effect? Tyndall effect means when a beam of light is passed through these mixtures, if it scatters, we say that it has Tyndall effect. If it doesn't scatter, if it goes straight away, we say that it does not show Tyndall effect. So your true solutions, since they are homogeneous in nature, they do not show Tyndall effect at all. While as our colloids and suspensions, because their particle size is greater than those of true solutions, they show this effect, they show the Tyndall effect. And finally, moving on to separation of the particles. The particles of true solution do not separate because they are homogeneous in nature. As far as the particles of colloids are concerned, they can be separated by not ordinary methods. They can be separated only by ultrafiltration. Special method of filtration is known as ultrafiltration. Their particles can be separated by ultrafiltration. As far as the particles of suspension are concerned, they do separate, or they separate ordinarily as well as by ultrafiltration method. So these are some points of distinction between true solutions, the colloids and the suspension. And it is all for today.